Notion now has support for offline mode, which is one of the biggest Notion updates of the year. This has been requested for so many years now, and I'm personally excited that I'll be able to continue writing and planning in my Notion pages without worrying about my internet connectivity. In this video, I'm super excited to share about it with you all in terms of what you can do with it, limitations, and whether there's any differences depending on your Notion pricing plan. If you find this video useful, be sure to like, subscribe, and turn on the notification bell. Let's dive right in. Let's first go over how to access and use offline mode. So to use offline mode, you can go to the top right hand corner, three dots, and then for any page that you want to use offline, you can toggle this available offline on, and that's going to start downloading your page. Once that's downloaded, you can go ahead and disconnect from the internet. And now you can see that it's working offline as well as when it was last synced. Now we can get into what you can do in this offline mode. For example, with the page text, it feels pretty much the same as usual. So I can type more text here and it feels the same as when I'm online as opposed to offline. You'll also notice that you won't be able to update your cover photo. So you can still change the icon here, but I can't change my cover photo at the moment. Then if I go to my images and embeds, you can see the file here, but I'm not able to download my file. And you can see the image, but then you can't see my Google Maps embed. Then underneath here, we have databases. Databases work the same as you would online and offline. I can add new pages. That's going to get synced when I'm back online again. And if I click here, you can see that I have added a child page inside here. So not all of your child pages are going to be downloaded unless you go to that specific page inside of a page to download that. So that's something to remember when using offline mode. And then for AI doesn't work if you're offline. And then for pages, again, if you just add a child page to your main page, it's not going to be able to be used offline. So you will need to turn that on specifically for each of the pages that you want to use offline. Another thing I wanted to go over is that if you type slash, you can see that most simple blocks are available with this offline mode, but you won't be able to do things, anything with Notion AI, anything to do with media besides adding code blocks and web bookmarks. Databases are available to be used, but you can't add these kinds of charts. And then some of the more advanced blocks like buttons are not available, but everything else works. So you could definitely set up a new Notion layout while you're in offline mode to be synced later. You'll just have to add all of these more advanced things in afterwards. So I do think that it's pretty useful already as it is, but of course I hope that there are more updates in the future where potentially our entire workspace just works offline. The other thing is the embeds. So as I showed with the Google Maps embed, it didn't work. And most of the other integrations that are available are not going to embed while offline. You can also now see what pages are shared offline by going to your settings, by going to the sidebar and then going to settings. And then you can see here the pages that you have for offline access. And you can also see pages downloaded by you versus downloaded by Notion. Next, let's go over the limitations of offline mode. So as I mentioned, there are some block types that are not supported with offline mode, which you can see if you type slash. And then the embeds don't necessarily work depending on the type of embed. Then there's databases. And for databases, it loads up to 50 pages that you have inside of here, but it's not necessarily going to load all of your child pages inside of your database entries. So if you have pages inside of pages, then you might run into more problems if you're using it offline. So you will have to individually download those. Then, as I mentioned, AI doesn't work in offline mode and the child pages. The other limitations and details to note as you're using offline mode is that if you're using it as a team and multiple people are using offline mode at the same time, then Notion is the one that is going to automatically decide on how to resolve those conflicts when you and your teammate go back online. So in that sense, there are some risks of data loss depending on how you're using offline mode, especially if you're working as a team. So I would recommend periodically, as much as possible, connecting you back to the internet whenever you can. Try not to stay offline for too long, or there could be issues when you actually do sync again. Another thing that you should keep in mind when using offline mode is that if you're doing it offline here, so available offline toggle on, you'll have to also toggle that on anywhere else that you want to actually use that page offline. Depending on the device that you're using, you'll have to toggle that on. So this available offline toggle is for each device. And another key thing about mobile use is that you will need to connect to Wi-Fi in order to sync back to your online Notion. Next, let's talk about the differences depending on your pricing plan. So in this case, for the offline mode, I think that Notion was quite generous in that the free plan can allow you to have unlimited offline pages. The only thing is that for the free plan, you will have to always click to turn on available offline for all of the pages that you want offline manually. However, if you have any of the other paid plans in Notion, Notion will automatically download your most frequent pages as well as your favorites so that you don't have to necessarily manually add them as the pages that you need to use offline. So that's the main difference between the pricing plan. So you will still be able to access offline mode completely on the free plan. It's just that you will have to do a bit more manual work in terms of turning on offline mode for any of the pages that you use often. Finally, I just wanted to share some of my tips for using offline mode in this current version of it. So I would say that for simple tasks and also for planning purposes, you can definitely use offline mode just to see what you have coming up, what tasks you might have, and all of these things. But I would recommend not relying on offline mode to be able to access all of your files and also for any of the embeds that you might want to use, and to remember to download child pages if you need to use those. Make sure that you have all of the pages that you want to access offline before going offline. Thank you so much for watching. Let me know your thoughts about offline mode. If you have any questions or comments about it, feel free to drop them below, and I hope to see you all in the next video.